this entire hour, I will be talking to a woman who has single-handedly, with one hand, her single hand, she has revolutionized the world of music. She's one of the hottest entertainers in the world, and she's got a body and also those six-pack abs to match. She's sold over 50 million albums. Just take that in. 50 million albums. And according to the Guinness Book of World Records, her name is the most searched for on the web. But you don't have to search for her anymore because she's here. She is right here. And you know who I'm talking about. Miss Janet Jackson!
20 years. Time flashes by like lightning in the sky. 20 years of questions come down to who am I?
5, 4, 3, 1.
While her brothers, the Jackson 5, were topping the charts with songs like ABC, acting came as easy as Do Re Mi to young Janet. She was only 10 years old when she landed the part of Penny on Good Times. But even then, her acting was dynamite. From there, she landed a role on Different Strokes. What you talking about, Janet? And then made sure everyone remembered her name on Fame. In 1986, Janet took control of her career.
I'm giving you back.
With the help of music masters Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis, and made music history with record-breaking hits. She was no longer Michael Jackson's kid sister. She was a multi-platinum superstar. With the entire world jamming to her distinct, nasty groove. After waiting a while for a follow-up album, her fans missed her so much, Janet delivered the groundbreaking masterpiece, Rhythm Nation.
Be a good boy and put this on.
She became the first artist ever to achieve 7 top 5 hits from one album. And after burning up the charts with albums like Janet and The Velvet Rope, she won a Grammy for All For You.
Copy that.
3, 2, 1. Miss Jackson has also proved to be box office gold with her critically acclaimed performance in Poetic Justice and her role opposite Professor Eddie Murphy in The Clumps. Had audience going nutty, nutty, nutty for her. But what has Janet done for us lately? Well, she has a new man, Jermaine Dupri. That's the way love goes. And she dropped 60 pounds to become the best-selling cover of Us Magazine ever. And she's released her brand new CD, 20YO. Her first single, Call On Me With Nelly, hit number 1 and proved that Miss Jackson still controls the music chart. When I think of you, Janet, I see a career as strong as your six-pack abs, girl. So when you let down your velvet rope today for an all-access pass into your life, know that all of us are so excited to have you here.
You ready?
Right. Ah! There she is! Janet Jackson. Now because Janet has agreed for me to be able to ask her 20 questions that she has never been asked before, because her album is 20YO, so I was like, well, we're gonna have to ask her 20 questions. So I have been coming up with these questions for so long, trying to figure out what you haven't been asked. So the first question is, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, the first question is, who would win in a wrestling match, Janet Jackson or LaToya Jackson?
My sister doesn't have any strength.
No?
No, she's so weak. Bless her heart, the heaviest thing that I think she's ever picked up is her purse.
Oh, really?
And they're not very big. She doesn't carry big bags.
Did you guys used to fight when you were little?
When I was a teenager, I was closer to my brothers. But see, I fought with one of my brothers, too.
Who did you beat down?
Randy.
Randy.
We were always going at it, and then we'd turn around and hold each other's hand across the street.
Really?
Yeah, and then we'd be at it again. I was out for blood, though. I was bad. I used to throw pool balls.
Pool balls?
From the pool table, the pool balls.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you draw blood ever?
No, I never did, but I could never catch him. That's what would anger me so. And so I would chase him, and he was always faster than me, so I'd get the pool balls, and I'd...
And get him.
Yeah.
All right, question number two.
Yes.
Have you ever had a diva tantrum where you just cuss somebody out?
I never have.
No.
I never have.
So what do you do when you're mad?
Either I hold it in. I internalize a lot.
Really?
That's not good. Yeah. I'll hold it in, or I'll be very vocal to someone who will listen. But I've never really
done it directly.
Cussed. Mm-mm. You know what? I'm lying.
Tell the truth.
It just hit me. Oh my God.
Who did you cuss out?
This lady on the street.
Really?
It just hit me. A friend of mine was in the store. I had to go, so I parked. And this lady is getting so close to my car, and she's in the car with her son. And I'm thinking, this lady is going to hit me. And sure enough, she hits me. So I get out of the car, and here she gets out of the car, and she starts going off. So I just get pissed off, and I give her peace of my mind, you guys. I really did at that point.
Oh, my gosh.
And then the next thing I know, I have an audience. I forgot about this. And all the people from the stores came out of the store, and they said, you know what? We liked Janet Jackson before, but now we love her.
Because she cussed somebody out. I love it.
That's not a good thing.
It's like,
no, that was...
Okay, next question. Is sex better in your 40s than it was in your 20s?
Oh, hell yeah.
Hell yeah?
That's enough of that.
Just hell yeah.
You can't compare.
Really, why?
That's enough of that, Tyra.
Okay.
It's way better.
Way better.
And my partner doesn't hurt at all.
So. Your partner?
Yeah.
Okay. So on a scale to 10, 1 to 10, how is Jermaine in bed?
He's off the charts.
He's off the charts.
Yeah, he really is.
Okay. Off the charts.
See, no, Tyra, you're getting ready to dig.
I am. All right, craziest place you've ever had sex?
I'm sorry.
Okay, well, Janet, I have to be honest. Like, I love you, and I've grown up listening to you, and so many of your songs are about sex. And, like, you guys know it, and then the interludes, the 30-second interlude, she's like, what are you doing? Why are you touching me there? No, I'm touching myself. Oh, that's me. So, that type of stuff. So I'm used to hearing Janet talk about sex, so I want to ask about it.
All right. Yes, your question, the craziest place?
Yeah.
In a public place.
Where?
You're going to get me in trouble, Tyra.
No, I'm not. Tell me.
On a plane, on an airplane.
Commercial? A private airplane.
Commercial, yes, I'm sorry.
A commercial?
Yes.
In the bathroom?
No. See, that's what makes it worse. Cut it out.
Wait, oh my gosh. So like, okay, so I can imagine like the seat or some kind of something.
Yeah.
Skirt on.
My seat.
Oh my gosh. Have you ever, okay, I'm going to ask her this, but we're going to take a break. Have you ever faked an orgasm?
I think on every album except for this one. Yeah.
We'll be right back with more Janet Jackson. Up next, whatever I ask, no matter how personal, Janet answers. What celebrity asked you out and you said no?
And later, I get the answer to a question I know no one has ever dared to ask Miss Jackson. ever.
You're in a room.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And you fart. And it stinks so bad. Do you own up to it? Or do you go, it stinks here. Who did that? No words are suitable to describe your swag, babe. And my body is an overdrive, then I have you, babe. If you like it, then I do it. But I go head to toe. That was a clip from the video of So Excited from Janet's hot new CD. 20YO, and we're celebrating her 2 decades in the music industry by asking Janet 20 questions she's never been asked before. Are you ready to continue?
Sure.
Sure. Let's go. Okay. Would you rather gain weight permanently, but have be able to keep your talent of singing and dancing, or lose or stay how you are permanently, thin permanently, but
and not be able to
have
sing.
No talent? No.
I'd
dance.
Have to gain weight.
The gain weight. Yeah.
It's my life. Mm-hmm. I love to dance and I love to sing, mm-hmm. and I can't imagine life without it.
Yeah. Okay, here's an interesting one. What is your worst hair weave disaster?
Disaster?
Yeah. Like you got the weave and you're like, dang, I just set 10 hours for this?
10 hours? That's how long it...
Mine used to take 10 hours.
Mine would take 18. I'd only get up to use the restroom.
Are you serious?
That was it. I used to be very patient, but I can't
do
that.
Not hair weave disaster, but no specific like hair weave.
I think I got I got extensions put into my hair, and I went to go get my hair cut. And I'm laughing because it's someone who's very dear to me, and I love her so deeply. And I think she was going through a lot in her life at the time, and she cut my hair. She cut it that long.
Oh, really?
She cut it all off. She cut my hair, I believe, with the hair.
Your natural hair with the hair weave.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh.
So I had
18 hours down the drain.
I went back the next day and did it all over again.
18 hours.
Another 18 hours.
Again. Oh, my gosh.
And yeah.
Well, I was obsessed with your hair and That's the Way Love Goes.
That's the Way Love Goes. Yes.
Remember the wet and wavy and
curly,
kind of
I love curly hair.
And you wore the bone necklace and all that. I got the same weave, girl. I tried to work it out. Check it out.
You're beautiful.
Thank you. I went to my hair weave lady.
Is that what that was supposed to be? Not to say that it doesn't look like I don't know. Don't even.
I
didn't mean it like that, but it looks good. You look beautiful on
it. I tried. My hair weave lady at the time, her name was Lynette LaFrance. What's up, Lynette LaFrance? Remember this one? I showed you the picture, we watched the video, and we tried, girl. We tried. We tried. We didn't get there, but you know. Okay. What celebrity asked you out and you said no?
Ooh. I know a date that I wish I would have said no to.
Come on.
I'm not telling you who it is.
Come on.
No.
Why not?
Because he might be watching.
Is it Q-Tip?
No.
No?
No.
Is it Justin Timberlake?
No.
No? Who else? What other rumors did
you have? No, I don't think you would. No one would ever know.
No? But you went on the date.
Yes. It was. I thought it was disastrous.
Okay, did he sing or did he act?
He's an actor.
That's it. Eddie Murphy?
No.
Okay, I'm really trying to think. 80s, 90s?
No, more recent.
Oh my gosh.
But
Jamie Foxx.
No.
No.
You're really searching for this.
Is he black or white? Is he Latin?
No, he's not black.
He's white.